This is the fifth anniversary of the collapse of Lehman Brothers, the biggest bankruptcy in American history. That event helped trigger the greatest economic crisis in the United States since the Great Depression. Have we taken adequate steps to prevent a recurrence? For more about that, we're joined in our studio by Heidi Moore. She's the finance and economics editor for the Guardian newspaper and is based in New York. So what have we done so far to prevent another banking collapse like we saw?
Well, we flailed a bit. So we have done things that were supposed to prevent another banking collapse, like passing the Dodd-Frank Act. It was an omnibus regulation bill that was supposed to prevent Wall Street from becoming too big to fail. Mm-hmm. And that really has been kind of the major effort that has happened. There were, of course, the bailouts at the time, the TARP bailouts, and then there was the quantitative easing stimulus by the Fed, which is also a result of the crisis at that time.
Are there things that we said that we would do to prevent this that we haven't done yet?
Yes, a lot. In fact, you can look at Dodd-Frank very specifically. There are hundreds of rules within Dodd-Frank that were left undone. It was passed in a hurry in 2009 in a very emotional time, and it was essentially a very long to-do list, a 900-page to-do list, and almost all of it is left undone. There are some good things that we've done, like create the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, mm-hmm. and also create the Financial Stability Oversight Council, which is a group of 14 regulators that meet about once a month. They're only supposed to meet once a quarter, and they talk about what's going on in regulation and the issues that they're facing. Those are two good things that came out of it. But what didn't come out of it was more separation between the risk-taking activities of banks and their lending. So that was, it's called the Volcker Rule, and that was supposed to be really one of the linchpins of how we were going to change the financial system, and that is nowhere. It is mired in bureaucracy.
So is it because of, why are the regulations not effective?
They're not effective largely because there's really no one pushing them forward. Wall Street has gotten its claws into it. What we know Wall Street as a money-making enterprise, but it's also a lobbying enterprise. And those lobbyists are the ones who know the financial sector best, and they advise Congress on how to write rules. So, for instance, one rule concerning derivatives had 85 lines in it, 75 of which were written by Citigroup lobbyists. So part of the issue is that Wall Street has a lot of influence over the rule writing process, and they are invested in making it weaker. And then the other side of it is that we have too little enforcement. The Securities and Exchange Commission and other regulators are perpetually underfunded, and they are also facing pressure from Wall Street to weaken their efforts, and their prosecutions are very rarely successful.
So is it accurate for some of these critics to say that perhaps we just need to do a better job of enforcing the laws that are on the books versus writing entirely new ones?
Well, we do need better laws only and new laws only because the financial system is becoming more and more complex. And writing laws allows us to explore how they've become complex mm-hmm. and to rein in that complexity or at least regulate it. But it's true that we also don't enforce very well what we already have. A lot of regulators just aren't incentivized to find wrongdoing. We have a whistleblower rule that's a part of Dodd-Frank that still hasn't been finalized. Mm. You have the structural issue that a lot of regulators are paid $50,000, $80,000, maybe $100,000 a year, but the bankers they're regulated are being paid millions of dollars a year. So there's a class system, quite literally a class hierarchy within Wall Street regulation.
So how big of a threat do we still face?
We face a pretty big threat, but just as with last time, we don't know what it is. Last time, we were blindsided by the mortgage crisis, even though there were a few oracles who said that they predicted it. No one could have predicted that the economy would be so bad, that income inequality would have been as bad as it is, that the economic recovery has stumbled along and is almost a kind of stagnation. No one predicted that.
Nope.
And we won't see that coming next time either, but it's worth it for regulators to take a look at assets that are priced way too high relative to what they're worth.
All right, Heidi Moore, thanks so much.
Thank you.
The conversation about the 2008 financial crisis continues tomorrow on the NewsHour, an interview with the man who headed up the Treasury Department back then, Henry Paulson.